संकर्षण कारण तोयसाई गर्भोदसाई च पयोभिसाई शेषस्य जस्यंस कलास नित्यानंदाक्षराम कृष्ण सच्चिदानंद विग्रह सत मीन्स प्रोडिमिनिटी ऑफ सत सत हैज कम फ्रॉम संदिनी कृष्ण सच्चित आनंद फर्स्ट बलदेव प्रभु सत इज द प्रीडोमिनेटिंग ड्यूटी ऑफ सत संधिनी विदाउट हिम नथिंग कृष्ण स्टैंड्स सिट्स ऑन दैट एंड देन चीत कृष्ण ही चीत एंड लादिनी ओ हरसेल्फ राधिका सो वेर नित्यानंद प्रभु बलदेव प्रभु राधिका and then Krishna. So three are always there. Oh, if not Sandini, no Vrindavan. No, the form of Krishna, Baladev Prabhu and anyone. So root of all these things, it seems that. Upon Sandini, Chit, Ananda and everything. So, Baladev Prabhu, himself is Nityananda Prabhu. First, Krishna, and then Baladev Prabhu. Baladev are two, like Krishna is two. Aishwarya and Madhurya. Those who took birth from the womb of Devaki is Vasudeva Putra, Vasudeva, like Narayan. They never go to Vrindavan, always in Mathura, sometimes to Dwarka. But who came from the womb of Devaki in seventh womb of Devaki, and by Jogmaya he was taken to the womb of Rohini mother in Gokul. And he mixed in fullest Baladev Prabhu. Baladev Prabhu was from before there. And he mixed in that. Understand? As Krishna, coming from the womb of Devaki, mixed in two arms of that Krishna, the son of Nanda and Jasoda, he mixed, immersed in that. Similarly, Baladev, who came from the womb of Devaki, he was what? Unseek. Manifestation. And the root Baladev Prabhu was in the Rohini womb, and he went there and he was immersed in that Baladev Prabhu. The Baladev Prabhu in Gokul is none different to Krishna. Only there are some differences of black complexion and golden complexion, and some float and singa and others. but both are of Vrindavan. Then, oh, from him, this Baldev Prabhu, comes Mool Shankarshan in Dwarka and Mathura, especially in Dwarka. Mool Shankarshan. And from them, oh, all, like Vasudev, Shankarshan, Pradyumna, Nirudh. They are Mool Shankarshan. And from Mool Shankarshan comes Mahashankarshan in Vaikuntha. He served in so many ways to Narayan. As Baldev Prabhu in Vrindavan, similarly Mool Shankarshan in Dwarka, and from there Mahashankarshan in Vaikuntha, in so many. And his one of the manifestations comes to this world, like Karnabdishayi Vishnu, mixing some worldly causes, not pure tattva. Himself is pure, but his actions are not pure. Though he is like a lotus in water, ocean, but yet, if world is demolished, then no need. Where he goes? He goes to Mahashankarshan, Karanabdi Sai Vishnu. And from Karanabdi Sai Vishnu, oh, so many universes. Thousand and crores of universe coming. And one part of the answer of the Karnabdi Sai Vishnu comes in that, each everywhere. Garbhodasai. And then Garbhodasai becomes Hiranya Garbha Brahma, and from him Bairaj Brahma. And thus creation is. And from Garbhodasai, in each heart, his Khirodashai, part of Khirodashai, all everywhere. He is called Paramatma, O Angusht Parman, Vishnu, like this. Yogi meditate them. And last is Shesh. What is Shesh? Shesh means remaining. What remaining? The last part of fraction of Baladev Prabhu is Shesh. Serving Mahavishnu, Garbhodasai, and so many ways. Asan, Basan, Bhushan, and so many things. And Baladev Prabhu to Krishna, Mool Shankarshan to Vasudev Krishna in Dwarka, Mahashankarshan to Vaikunthapati, in this way. But Shesh is the Lord's fraction. So Nityananda Prabhu is himself Baldev Prabhu, none different to Baldev Prabhu. So we should try to know Baldev Prabhu. So without the mercy of Nityananda Prabhu, we cannot do anything. He is Akhanda Guru Tattva. And that is why he killed Dhenukasur. Oh, what Dhenukasur? Oh, he was ignorance. Ignorance, like an ashes. Ash. So Nityananda Prabhu is that. He also cut the head of Nomharshan. Why he cut out? Because he was not giving proper respect to Vaishnavas. And Guru Baladev Prabhu, at once he cut out. And he at once inspired a little boy of that who is
son of
Lomharshan Sutta. Ugrashrava. He is Ugrashrava. Why Ugrashrava? Baldev Prabhu gave him power. What he will hear, he will remain forever. And he will never forget anything. And without reading Vedas, Upanishads, Shastra, Vedanta, everything, all the Purans and all, everything should come out in his heart. And quickly. Oh, by the mercy of Baladev Prabhu. So, by the mercy of Nityananda Prabhu, oh, everything can come. So those who are not taking shelter of this Baldev Prabhu or Nityananda Prabhu, really they are what?
Animals.
So we should glorify Nityananda Prabhu. Also, we see from the pastimes of Nityananda Prabhu that he took birth not as a brother here in Navadvip. Mahaprabhu took birth in Navadvip from the home of Sachidmaya. And prior to this, so many years before, Nityananda Prabhu took birth in Adai Ekchakra. Ekchakra. Madhvar Padmavati and father
Adai
Pandit. And when he was some small boy, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, he used to play only the parts of Baladev Prabhu in Krishna pastime. Sometimes Lakshman in Ram, always. They were in a group, so many children, so many boys. And they used to play sometimes Krishna pastime, sometimes Ram, sometimes Bara, sometimes Nishingha, and all. Especially where Baldev is needed, oh, they used to do. And you know, we will glorify in evening or in
10 o'clock
we can. So he became once what? Lakshman. And he was in the side of Ram. And Ravan was one side. And thus he has told everything to his companions, that I will fight with Meghna and he will shoot me with arrow and then I may be senseless. You should go to Himalayas and bring jadi booty, some
medicine,
herbs, and give in my nose and then I will quickly
revive.
Then they began to
fight
each other. And Lakshmana was fighting.
Meghnad.
And Meghnad suited him. And when he suited, he became senseless, Nityananda Prabhu. And all began to weep. They never remembered that what Nityananda Prabhu has told to bring herbs from Himalaya. And they all for him began to weep and they went to village. And they told this, that, oh, Nityananda Prabhu is about to die. His father, mother and all villagers came and became very
upset.
Oh, he was about to die, no breathing, nothing. Then anyone told, old man told that, oh, you are playing this, what Nityananda Prabhu told in the last. If he will be senseless, what to do? Oh, then remember. Oh, he told what we were very upset. And then one being like a monkey and he jumped up and went to Himalaya. Not Himalaya, anywhere. And he took some pieces of stone like Himalayas, Gandhamadhan Parvat. And from that herb was
brought
and given in the nose of Nityananda, and then so this is how he used to be observed in that. We should try to observe totally in bhajan. How you can? If you have a relation to Nityananda Prabhu and he is giving all these things, what thing? Very strong relation with Krishna. And then everything will inspire, he will inspire. So then you can. Without Nityananda Prabhu mercy, you cannot do. So, the Guru inspired by, given power by Nityananda Prabhu, he can help the devotees. Otherwise, a bogus Guru cannot. For a bogus Guru, Nityananda Prabhu will not inspire anything. So, if the Guru is sincere, and he is Mahabhagavat, Bhagavat at least, then his mercy will come. At least he will be sincere. He should be. If Madhyamadhikari, but Madhyamadhikari in what stage? At least Madhyam Uttam he should be. Otherwise he cannot do anything. So if by the mercy of Nityananda Prabhu you are so much fortunate to have the mercy of Nityananda Prabhu, oh then you can observe like him or others. Even like Murari Gupta, he sing the peak feathers and he remembered Krishna past times and he was in senseless state. So this Nityananda Prabhu doing all these things, like in the meantime when he became about 12 hours?
Oh,
a renounced order sannyasi came. And he told his father, oh, this boy is very good, very intelligent, and very religious. I want that I should travel whole India, pilgrims, holy places. Please give me this boy for this. He will help me. Otherwise, now I am old, I cannot do anything. Then he began to weep, but at once, anyhow, he remembered the past of Ramachandra and Lakshman. Remembered that Dasarath never wanted to do like this, that he should give his Ram and Lakshman to
Vishwamitra.
But Vasishtha told that, oh, very good thing. This is the mercy of Vishwamitra that he has come. At once give up. Otherwise he may curse you and you will be all
ruined
with your all
dynasty
and everything. And anyhow, he gave Nityananda Prabhu. And then with Nityananda Prabhu, that sannyasi traveled whole India, pilgrims, South India, West India, North India, East India, everywhere. Not only one time, so many times. Especially in South India. So much. Now he has become some grown up more. And he went in his last trip. Where? Pandharpur. And there, luckily, Vishnu Puri, the guru of Madhavendra Puri met him. You know?
From
Lakshipati. Lakshipati na Vishnu. Lakshipati Tirtha. Tahar Shishya Theravada. Udari Paramparate Vishnu Puri. Lakshipati Tirtha. And, oh, both met. Lakshipati Tirtha was so much attracted to Nityananda Prabhu, as even he was like a young boy, and he wanted to
initiate
him, Nityananda. And then Nityananda Prabhu strictly gave that mantra to him. Oh, do you want to give this mantra to me? Yes, I want. Oh, he told this mantra and he made him disciple and then he initiated him. And after initiation, oh, Madhavendra Puripad made him. Oh, always weeping, always observed. He Dina Dayadranath Mathuranath Kadavalakkase. He Daita, He Deva, He Daita, He. All this, always weeping. And he was so much vigor in age also, so much.
Senior.
So he always, Nityananda Prabhu respected him like his guru, Shiksha Guru. After that, Nityananda Prabhu came to Vrindavan. And he was searching everywhere. Oh Krishna, where? Oh Kanaiya, my brother, where you are, where you are. He used to take the embrace of deers, even.
Cows, deer.
Cows also. Where my Kanaiya is? Where my Kanaiya is? Everywhere. The covered boys, oh, they began to fear that he is ghost or what, that he is embracing us. Anyhow, when he was in Vrindavan, in a temple, he heard a voice, oh, Kanaiya is not here. He has taken birth in Mayapur Navadvip Dham. And his name is also changed. And now his name is Sachinandan Gaurhari.
Nimai.
So if you want to meet him, you can go there. And you can meet him. He is waiting for you. So Nityananda Prabhu quickly went to Navadvip Dham. And he crossed the Ganges. And there was a beautiful ashram. Nandacharya Garden.
Ishodhyan.
Ishodhyan, Nandanacharya ashram, kuti,
cottage.
And he used to do kirtan always. And it was some far away from Navadvip, Mayapur. As the, have you gone?
Navadvip.
So on the bank of, near bank of Ganges, nearer to Sarup, Ganja and Godrum and Navadvip. There was no any way when I went first with my Gurudev. About 50 years before. So you can think at that time. So Nityananda Prabhu was hiding himself. If my Kanaiya is here in Navadvip, he must come to me and then I will know that, oh, he is my Kanaiya. Otherwise, I will return. So he was waiting there. And in the evening, Mahaprabhu, in Shiva's Angan, with other devotees, to Gadadhar Pandit, Shiva's Pandit, his four brothers and all, he told that, oh, such any Mahapurush has come, Mahabhagavat. So you should at once go and search him and bring him. So Shiva's Pandit and all others went to search. They searched everywhere in all the temples, in the houses of all the devotees, till evening, but they could not search. Then Mahaprabhu took with him Gadadhar Pandit, Shivas and all other associates, and he quickly went to the house of Nandana Acharya. And he saw that a very tall, very healthy. A saint is there, Mahapurush, and he was standing, and Nityananda Prabhu also standing, each other talking with eyes. And then Mahaprabhu quickly run towards Nityananda Prabhu, ran towards Mahaprabhu, and they embraced each other and became saints. Then, what became? Then Gadadhar Prabhu in the from the behind court. Curtain. Varaha Pidam Natavarabapu Karnayo Karnikaram Vibradavasaha Kanakapisham Bajayanti Chabalam Randhana Venuradar Sudayo Puranyan Go Prabandai Vindaranam Savadarapanam Pravishatagi. Oh! Nityananda Prabhu, and they began to do hunkar. Hunkar, you know?
Roaring.
Roaring, bow. And all they became more and more excited. Excited?
Excited.
And then, Mahaprabhu took him, Nityananda Prabhu, and took him to where? In Shivasangan. Shivasangan in the wife of Srivas was Malini. Malini saw that he is like his son, and he took in her lap. And thus Nityananda Prabhu was always there with his mother, Malini Devi. And after then, everything, so many pastimes of Nityananda. One day, Malini Devi was weeping. Nityananda Prabhu told, "Mother, why you are weeping?" Oh, a crow came and took my golden or silver full of ghee. Oh, you are weeping for this. Oh, crow, come on, and crow. And he kept that container there. She became very happy. Sometimes, in the mood of a very small child, he used to run to Sachi Maiya without any cloth. He used to take his dhoti, turban. Oh, mother, where is Kanhaiya? And then Mahaprabhu saw him, Nimai. Oh, he gave his and tightened in his waist. Thus, always observed, not remembering that time any male or anything. So there are so many pastimes. We will try to tell all these things in evening class. It will be better that you can come here just before 5. I may come at 5, and you should come before, and you should do all the kirtan of Nityananda Prabhu. You must come, and all should come, and you should glorify by kirtan, also by meaning. What is the meaning of that kirtan? And go on doing. At about 10:30 or 11, I may come, and you should bring all the worth paraphernalia of Abhishek, or also some very good drops.
That's a green coconut.
Green coconut. 2-3. And Nityananda Prabhu and Gaur Prabhu, they should come out here, decorate them. And we will do Abhishek and some glorification. Then in evening, again kirtan, and we will glorify. Gaur Pramanand.
Otherwise, come and have a class in there.